Hello, a very good afternoon to all our friends out there. I know I'm preaching to the converted. Many of you are involved in the social space, in the philanthropic space, and doing whatever we can to make a difference, especially today in amidst the COVID-19 situation. I know that we are going to discuss about the way forward, what we're going to do, the different things, the different initiatives. All these things are important, but perhaps what I'll take the opportunity to do is to revisit the fundamentals. Not so much about what we are going to do, how we're going to do it, where we're going to do it, but why are we doing it? It might seem painfully obvious. I think a lot of us assume that we're all on the same page, that we should move beyond that and let's really explore the details. The details do matter. But I find that it's useful to remind ourselves, why exactly are we doing what we do and how vitally important I feel it is. Now imagine, I think many of us are very good, and in Singapore particularly, we're very good at doing things, jump into the details. But the why part, I do ask that we spend a bit of time to reflect and remind ourselves and reinvigorate ourselves to remotivate and inspire ourselves about why this is so fundamentally important. Now, there are many things that we need to do in a country, whether it's, you know, keeping the economy going, which is important, it creates jobs for people. How do you deal with environmental issues, transport, education, et cetera, et cetera. Now, so I sometimes use the analogy of a strategy map. If you were to have a strategy map of Singapore, what would it look like? I know that many of us, when we are free, we don't sit down and start doodling what the strategy map of Singapore would look like. But imagine if there was on one page, or one PowerPoint slide, you were able to just pen down and draw out and sketch out all the different components that goes into keeping the country going, the things that we need to do, the mega trends that shape us, and perhaps at the foundational pieces, what's really core. What are the things that, what's the secret to our success that will ensure that whatever comes, whatever the future may hold, we would be able to deal with it. Now, so imagine in your own mind, what would that picture look like? And I just want to focus on the foundational pieces. What would be the key to our success? What's the secret to making sure that, you know, whatever the future holds, whatever, whether it's COVID-19, whether it's whatever crisis, are we able to deal with it and to achieve the outcomes that we want? So in my mind, people is the key to our success, and we all know that. It's a motherhood statement, but what is it about people? There's a competency part, how we are able to organize ourselves, our skills, our ability, how we deliver the outcomes. I mean, that's the part that I think many of us will be familiar with. We will spend our time organizing ourselves to do that, and we can't drop the ball on that, and it's fundamentally important. But there's another component, which is, so that part I call the heart part. But the other part is really about the heart. It's about whether are we prepared to not just do the job and do the thing, but are we prepared to go the extra mile? Are we prepared to sacrifice for one another? Are we thinking more about we and not just me? Are we thinking more about the future and not just today? And I think intuitively all of us know that. In any organization, what makes a difference between a good and great organization is that, you know, you're not just functionally doing something, you're actually literally going the extra mile for each other, the team, for your boss, for the cause, for the purpose. And I think at a nation, at a national level, it's the same thing. A people that begins to care about others and not just self, I think you begin to move to a very different dimension. In many countries, you're just running from pillar to post, from one election cycle to another. The demands of the public is basically how things benefit me today, here and now. That's human nature. But I think what makes us human is also the capacity to care, to have compassion, to have empathy, and how do you bring that out into practice? So how do you actually nurture this value in a society? Now, I don't think it's about, you know, government proclaiming and therefore a new set of national values, you recite it every day and it's going to happen, it's not. But I think the schools call it values in action today, and I think it's a very apt term. I'm not sure the schools necessarily get it right all the time. Some do it better than others, but values in action is exactly what it is. Values are realized in action. And it's really about the values of thinking about others, putting others before self. It's about love, compassion, empathy, whatever that comes to mind along those lines. And I think, don't we all feel that we do want a society, to live in a society like that, where we're not just looking out for the bottom line, but we are looking out for each other as well. So if indeed that is true, whether at the national, at the nation level, at a company level, then if that is indeed so, and that's a quality that we need to nurture, the heart and soul of our nation, then the question is, how do you bring that about? Is it just moral education, talking about it? In my mind, there's only one way in which we can realize this. From a secular perspective, religion, faith probably will play a part in it. But from a secular perspective, what's going to make a difference? The only platform that I know of is in giving. Not just money, but particularly time. When we volunteer, when we commit our lives into the lives of others, that's where I think we begin to have the opportunity to learn to be grateful. We will learn not to take things for granted. We learn to be circumspect about the things that we are preoccupied with. We learn to put into practice love, compassion, empathy, kindness. And if you think about it, what other ways do we have in a very non-prescriptive, non-preachy way to begin to instill those values in all of us? Which is why giving, volunteering, becomes vitally important. So the issues that we are grappling with today, which is in this space, it's a lot more important than you realize. Because for the social sector, it's not just about helping the disabled, the disadvantaged, the blind, the poor, etc., etc. It's an opportunity for us to bring on board the rest of society so that they can partake in that journey to make the difference, to improve the lives of those who are disadvantaged. But importantly, the KPI, if you would like to define it that way, is also about the transformative effect for the giver. Would every giver, every volunteer, come out of that journey a changed person, a better person? Imagine if we define that as one of our key requirements. You begin to think about the whole philanthropic journey differently. You begin to think about the whole volunteering experience differently. You begin to actually care about how that change effect begins to affect the volunteers and the giver themselves. I think it actually also adds to what we do because they become more committed, more regular. They are keen to do more. They begin to drag their family members along, their colleagues in the companies along. So, why this is so important is because I think this is, as far as I can, that I know of, that we can begin to build a fundamentally different society. And what is wonderfully empowering is that you don't even need to wait for government to do this. All of us, in our own way, can make the difference. Me, myself, my family, I can do that. If you're a captain of industry, you say that, you know what, I never thought of my CSR program that way, but maybe this is my contribution to building something very different. And perhaps if you then begin to embark on that journey where everyone in your company begins to partake in that experience, and you're also curating the experience so that they change. One company does that, another, and as it goes on, slowly but surely, society begins to change because society comprises individuals. And if we can see how individuals change, society changes along with us. And as more of us get involved on a regular basis, we can begin to program, we can begin to actively do preventive work. So whether for those who are disadvantaged in different ways, we can begin to be able to structurally make a difference to their lives as well. So it's a virtuous cycle in many ways. So I'll pretty much end off with that. I know that it might seem painfully obvious, but I think it's useful to remind ourselves why it is so very, very important for us to do this. Because I know of no other way in which our society can be different. And I think for us in Singapore, it's worth endeavoring to build a fundamentally different society. And it's all within our control. So with that, thank you very much.